galleries upstairs. One was a series of photographs in which she took text from books, often books that had to do with East-West encounter, like Robbie Solusha. And then she slightly cut them out and put them into the Malaysian landscapes. So these are the Kuala Lumpur projects. So you can see her text. It's like a combat part of darkness. And the idea that in the colonial period, there was a sense that the West could master the East, with their books and their texts and their knowledge. And then here she was changing her knowledge. She was putting them back into the landscape where it would decay, and sort of creating a new story. And these actually sort of gorgeous, almost 4x5 black and white photographs. And on this side, I'm sorry, these are really beautifully printed. Again, this is the text, those are made from roots in portraits. Simran also made a series of necklaces that were made of beads that were made of individual pages of books. And she was interested in art museum because we do everything is very pristine and very perfect. These sort of ancient, beautiful things in vitrines. And she, for her, that kind of fetishized art. So she said, oh, I made these necklaces that can never be sold. It's kind of inspiring me. Why don't I put those necklaces, triple pearl, into the museum and see what happens? And actually, most people just took them as incredibly precious art. But very beautiful. So, after, by 2009, I worked on the perspective series for 5 years. My greatest achievement was to get the museum to hire a full-time contemporary curator. And now, the next project I'm working on, by the way, is to get a full-time Southeast Asian curator. So I think that increasing the knowledge is an ongoing project. So in the middle, I did this project called Gardening. The royal paintings of Jodhpur. Jodhpur is a Rajput kingdom in the northwest desert of India. And from the 16th, 17th, 18th, 19th century, the Hindu kings who lived there patronized smallish paintings on paper. There were many Hindu courts that patronized for painting. Often they were secular themes and portraiture, polo. Sometimes they were Hindu sacred texts. Sometimes they were also poor people of the trees. And of those schools, Jodhpur was considered not so exciting. But I had the opportunity to go in there sometimes into this world of the palace just by sheer persistence and politeness. And they led me into this world. And what I found were hundreds and hundreds of paintings that were huge and gigantic and totally different. Every book said paintings kind of bad, and then it gets really bad by the 19th century. So I came back and I was in graduate school and I said I want to work on these particular paintings. And I could actually talk them into this. So I started this project, I don't know, like 1994. When we created that exhibition in Washington, D.C., I knew I had one chance. I should pick important paintings. And what I did was I picked paintings from the first 120 years from three names and three successful rulers. And I tried to show how in any particular king's reign, he was connected across North India to larger economic and social movements. artwork